Hello guys, so in this video I want to talk about dot product, where we're going to discuss the definition of the dot product and its meaning. So first we're going to take the dot product of two vectors a and b. But before that, remember that we have a number. We can think about the number as the length of the line segment. But we can just take a number and make a vector by assigning the direction to that line segment. So in other words, a vector is going to be some quantity with a magnitude and direction. Next step, what do we want to do? We want to express our vectors in terms of coordinates if we want to find the dot product using coordinates of our vector. So first, let's take some vector A and Cartesian coordinates x, y. Then I'm going to put my vector at the origin. And what else do we have? I have two unit vectors along x-axis and y-axis. I'm going to name them vector I with coordinates 1, 0 and vector j with coordinates 0, 1. And then you can see if I'm going to extend my I by 3 and I'm going to extend my j by 3, where like I'm going to put j at the ending point of I, then I'm going to express my a as 3i plus 3j, or in other words, a is going to have coordinates 3 and 3. So let's define dot product using algebraic definition. So for that, let's take a vector A with coordinates A1 and A2 and a vector B with coordinates B1 and B2. Then I'm going to define that A dot B is going to be A1 times B1 plus A2 times B2. Or in other words, the product of X components plus the product of Y components. And one interesting observation, if you're going to take two vectors and find their dot product, then as a result, you're going to obtain a scalar. Next, let's define a dot product using a geometric definition. So for that, I'm going to take vector A and B, but I'm going to think about them as a, like line segments. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to attach them to the same point. And then if I'm going to attach them to the same point, there's going to be an angle alpha between them. Then a dot product between A and B is going to be equal to the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times cosine alpha. And remember, if A is equal to A, if A can be written in terms of coordinates A1 and A2, then the magnitude of A is going to be just square root of A1 squared plus A2 squared. Okay, but we know like Renard's definition, but what is the meaning of the dot product? What does it measure? So for that, let's make sure that the quantity that our dot product is going to measure is not going to depend on the vector's length. So for that, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make a unit vector from vector A. For that, I will take just A and divide by its magnitude. And then you can see that if I'm going to take the magnitude of that vector, I will obtain that magnitude of A over magnitude of A is going to be equal to 1. And again, like that works because the magnitude of A is a scalar, so by one of the properties of the vector, I can factor that scalar out of the magnitude. After that, you can observe that if I'm going to have two unit vectors, or in other words, like vectors whose magnitude is equal to 1, then A dot B is going to be equal to just cosine of alpha. So to understand like the meaning of the dot product, we need to take a look at a unit circle, and then we need to analyze what does it mean that the dot product of two unit vectors is going to be equal to cosine of alpha. So let's take a unit circle and let's take two unit vectors A and B, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to just place any two vectors randomly on my unit circle. And then I'm going to have an angle alpha between them. And here we need to remember, if we have a unit circle in xy plane and I have some point in angle alpha, then what is like cosine of alpha in that case? Cosine of alpha is going to be just projection of point A onto x-axis. So that's why if I'm going to take my vector B and consider its projection onto vector A, then that projection is exactly is going to be equal to cosine of alpha. So we can see that the dot product of two unit vectors, it just corresponds to projection of one vector onto another vector. Next, let's do some examples. Let's take a unit circles and four vectors A, B1, B2, and B3. Then you can see that vector B1 is going to make an acute angle with vector A. So that's why cosine of alpha is going to be strictly bigger than zero. Or in other words, all vectors on right-hand side of vector B2 are going to make a positive angle. But vector B2 itself, the dot product is going to be equal to zero. But if I'm going to take a vector B3, then vector B3 is going to make a pi angle between angle A and B. Or in other words, the product is going to be negative. So on this picture, you can see that every time I'm going to take some vector A, then if I'm going to consider the orthogonal vector B2 to my vector A, then the whole family of vectors are going to be divided into three like big subsets. Vectors which makes a positive angle, vectors which make a zero angle, and vectors which make a negative angle. So you can see that the meaning of the dot product from one side is going to be projection of one vector to another vector, but from other side is going to be difference in directions between vectors A and B. In other words, if you're going to take two vectors, then the dot product is going to change between negative 1 and 1. When 1 means they have the same direction, negative 1 the opposite, and A dot B is going to be in between. Okay, so in my next video, what I'm going to do, I'm going to talk about applications of the dot product. Okay guys, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, let me know and have a nice day. Bye.